What's up guys, I'm Nomadic, and in this video I'm going to be showing you my secret method that I use to build drums that are really fat and hit super hard. So this is actually the exact process I use to build all my drums and my drum kit MPC drums, and in this video I'm going to be showing you exactly how I did that. In this video it's going to be divided into two parts. So the first part I'm going to show you exactly how I did it in the MPC, which is how I built all the drums in the first place. And in the second part, I'm going to show you exactly how you can take the same methods that I used on the MPC and apply it to Ableton Live, which is a digital version of a hardware sampler. So I'm going to show you how you can do it both ways. And without further ado, let's get down to business. All right, so the key to this method is a process called drum layering. Drum layering is basically when you take two or three different sounds together and you blend them together to create a bigger sound. So in this example, I'm gonna be blending several kicks and several snares together to create a bigger kick and a bigger snare. And I'm gonna show you exactly how you do it. So right now I have these two kicks here. And if you listen to them, this is one, and this is the second one. They sound different. So basically the key to drum layering is you wanna find two different sounds that are dominant in different frequency ranges. So kick one, it sounds to me, it sounds great, but it sounds more focused on the high end. And then when I listen to kick two, it sounds more focused on the low end. It sounds a little bit deeper. So what you wanna do, drum layering is basically taking kick one and kick two, blending them together into one sound, but taking the deep parts of kick two and the high parts of kick one to create one sound that sounds better than the original. So that's the key. So I'm gonna just start by loading one kick onto pad one, and I'm going to load kick two onto pad two. So I have both of them loaded up here. So when you're on the MPC, I know you can do this in the MPC 1000. In the 2000 XL, you have to actually load the pads separately, or you have to load the samples separately per pad. So I'm gonna have two kicks like this, and if I want to play them together, if I want to layer them, all you have to do, you just have to go mode, and then you go into program, and then you tab over into the mute section, and this is JJ OS2 XL, by the way. You just have to hit the first pad that you want to layer, and you change the mode to simult 2. Simult 1 will let you record Simult 1 will play both sounds at the same time, but it won't let you record it. So I just prefer Simult 2. And the target is going to be pad 2. So when you hit it, you hear both sounds at the same time instead of just one. So once you have that down, the next thing you want to do is you want to filter each drum separately. So kick two, it sounds good, but I want to focus on the deep part of it. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to program. I'm going to go back to kick two. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit the filter section, and I'm going to hit low pass filter. And I'm going to bring the filter down so I can really dial in on that low frequency. And then I like to add the resonance. I really like the filters in this machine. Really turn up the resonance to bring that low end out. And then when you hit the first pad, it'll play both of them together. And you can play with the levels too. So you can turn one up or one down. That's kick two you're hearing right now. Maybe I want to bring this up a little bit. So now it sounds deeper and it sounds fatter. And then what I want to do is I want to add some compression to make it hit really hard. So if you just go to effects, turn on the master compressor, It'll hit a little bit harder. You can even use a little bit of EQ if you want. But I think the compressor is all you need for now. So that's pretty good. I like how that kick sounds. So now let's do the same thing, but let's do it for the snare. So I'm just gonna go to mode. I'm gonna go back to the program and I'm gonna go back to the sample screen. I'm gonna load one snare on here. Load all these snares up across the pads here. So here's my snares. So I'm gonna listen to them right now. And what I'm hearing, it sounds like this snare is the low one. So I wanna dial in on the low frequencies of snare one, and I wanna layer it with snares two and three, but with the low end being more focused on snare one. So I'm gonna do the same thing. I'm gonna go mode and I'm gonna go back to program. And then I'm gonna go to filter. This snare, I'm gonna apply low pass filter. And I like to turn the resonance up to bring in that low character. And then I'm gonna go back to the mute screen, and then I'm gonna hit simult 2. And this time I'm gonna set target to be pad A6 and A7. And you can hear both of them at the same time. So now at this point, it's just a matter of playing with it. So I'm gonna turn these down so I can hear what it sounds like. I think this one I wanna bring out the high end a little bit more. So if you're on the 2000XL and you only have low pass filters, the trick you can do is just turn on low pass filter, but just increase the resonance. And it's gonna make it sound brighter instantly if you don't have high pass filter. And then I'm gonna bring this one back a little bit. And there you have it. You have a kick and you have your snare. All right, so now I got Ableton Live pulled up and I have the exact same drums in here as I had in the MPC section of this video. So just like I said in the last section, the key to having a really great drum sound is through the process of drum layering, which means you take the sound that you want in question, so the kick, let's say, and you find two different kicks that are really dominant in different frequencies. So this kick right here is the one I'm using that's dominant in the high frequencies. And this kick here that I'm using is dominant in the low frequencies. I can hear a lot more sub-frequencies from kick two than kick one. And for that reason, I decided to use these two drums to layer them together and play them at the same time to create a drum sound that is bigger and stronger. So how do you do that in Ableton Live? So all you need to do is pull up a MIDI track. And if you go to instruments and you take drum rack, you drag and drop it on. And if you look at it, you have basically the same thing as, you know, an MPC. I have 16 pads and I like to work this way because it reminds me of being on an MPC. So I'm gonna go to the drums and I'm gonna play with them. And these are the two kicks I wanna use. So what I'm gonna do, just like the MPC, I'm gonna drag and drop one kick on one pad, this being the deeper one. I like to always start with the subbier one because I feel like I'm like building it up, but I mean, this is just preference. So I have one kick on pad one, and I have the other kick I want to use, and I'm putting it on pad two. So now if I play the keyboard on Ableton, if I hit C, it's going to play kick two, but if I hit C sharp, it's going to play kick 01. So now how do I get it so when I hit one button, it plays both, right? So all you need to do is click this right here. It's gonna open the chain editor so you can see exactly all your samples within drum rack and you can change the settings. So what you wanna do to play them both with one pad, just like you do on the MPC, all you have to do is click IO, input output. And here it's gonna tell you the MIDI data. It says when you hit key C1, it's gonna play kick two. And when you play C sharp one, it's gonna play kick 01. So if you change the second pad, instead of C sharp 1 to just C1, when you hit C1, it's gonna play both, as you can hear, which is exactly what I want. So once I have that down, I'm gonna go into each one separately and play with them, because that's kind of what you would do on if you're on the MPC anyway, right? So I'm gonna go to kick 02 to play around with it. And by the way, with Ableton Live, something that really drove me nuts is when I hit the pad, I like to hit it to hear what I'm doing. But every time I hit it, the screen kind of switches on me. And if you want to stop that, just click this arrow button and it'll go away. So I can click it and like hear it, but it's not going to change the screen or anything, so I can play with it. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to turn the second one off. Going to listen to the first one. And this is the bass one. This is the subby one. So I want to play with this, and I want to emphasize the low frequency, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to filter this down just like on the MPC. And in order to do that, you click this square right here, the filter button. You click that, and then every time you hit it and you turn this frequency knob, you're going to be able to apply a low pass filter just like you do on the MPC. So let's say hypothetically, I wanted to change the tuning. I wanted to tune this down a little bit, make it a little bit deeper. And I wanted to filter it down just to emphasize the low frequencies, right? So I would just pick low pass filter, and this button right here changes the filter type. So Ableton comes with 5 different types, clean just being the regular, you know, no nonsense filter that, you know, Ableton uses all the time. But these two, OSR and MS2, these are specifically designed to be filters that emulate analog devices. And I tend to prefer to use these two because I feel like the filtering is kind of what gives analog devices their character. So I kind of try to emulate that in Ableton Live. So I pick either OSR, MS2, you can experiment and figure out which one you want to do. And then I bring the frequency down, so it's really deep, just focused on the deep frequency. And then what I like to do is I like to drive it with this knob, which is exactly what I do with analog devices. I feel like when you drive analog devices, that's really when you get the unique, strange character that you can't really emulate in the computer that well. But I like to do it here anyway. So I turn the drive up, so it really hits hard in the low end. And then what I'll do is I'll go to the second kick and turn this one back on, and you'll be able to hear. Now I have a much bigger, stronger drum than what I started with. So the last thing I like to do is, now that I have this drum sound, I like it, but to me, it still sounds like two drums. It doesn't really sound like they're glued together. So what I always like to do is I like to finish it up with some compression. So I go into audio effects, I use the glue compressor, which is, the title is exactly what I want it for. And I like to use this preset, bass low extender. And what that does is it glues both drum sounds together, and it really makes it punch and hit really hard. So I'm just gonna drag and drop it, and you can hear. Now it sounds a lot better. So that's how you layer kicks in Ableton Live. Now I'm going to show you how you can do snares. So I'm just going to do the exact same thing. I'm just going to create a new MIDI track. I'm going to rename this one, and I'm going to call this kick. And then this one I'm going to call snare. I prefer to have two separate tracks because I would rather just apply the effects just on one track for one drum sound. I like to just build one sound. So here I'm gonna do snare. I'm gonna do the exact same thing. I'm just gonna drag and drop the drum rack, and then I'm gonna go into this folder of the drums I wanna use, and it's the same thing. So the snare, I'm going through them, I'm listening to them. And I'm hearing more low end from snare one, so I'm just gonna do the same thing. Drag that one there. I like the hit on that one, I like the transient. Just gonna drag them all in there. And then I'm gonna change the receive to be the same, C1. So they're all hitting, I like how they sound. But let's say I wanna, you know, filter this one, first one, emphasize that low end character. So I'm just gonna change the filter again. Turn these off. Oh, same thing, click the arrow. Bring the filter down. I wanna hear more drive, so bring that drive up a bit. And then maybe what I would wanna do, cause you can do this in Ableton, you can actually use high pass filtering as well. You can't do that in the 2000 XL, unfortunately. But let's say this one, or not that one, this one. I think this one has more high detail. So what I wanna do, I wanna maybe high pass filter this. Make it really high. Really crispy. And then bring up the resonance. It sounds super crispy. And then maybe drive it a little bit. I think it sounds good. And then layer it together. Yeah, that sounds really good. Yeah, I mean, this whole thing is just experimentation. You know, it's not like there's one particular way to do it. But for me personally, when I layer the drums, I think the most important qualities is number one, sound selection. Number two, it's playing with the filters, like changing the frequency and resonance and drive and stuff like that. And then third is using compression. I think those are the most important effects. And then sometimes you might need to use EQ just to mess around a little bit. But those three things are the most important in my opinion. So really quickly, just like before with the kick, I'm gonna do glue compressor. Just use regular glue compressor. Soft clipper on, and maybe just drop this a bit. And there you go, kick and snare. There you go, that's the tutorial. All right, well that's the video. Hopefully you found this useful. If by any chance you're having a hard time doing this, just grab my drum kit. It'll save you a lot of time, and all the drums in there sound really great. And with that being said, I wish you the best of luck in your drum layering endeavors, and I'll see you later.